The following is a non-profit fan dub. The Adventure Zone is owned by the McElroys, Carrie Peach, and First Second Books. Links in the description to support the official Elite Brave Adventurers.
Back.
Oh, it's me, your dungeon master and best friend. I know what'll turn those frowns upside down. I'm here to level you up.
All right.
It's about time.
Magnus, you are now a level 4 fighter.
That was so much easier to go into the gym.
Merle, you are now a level 4 cleric specializing in the nature domain.
All hail mighty Pan.
Taako, you are now a level 4 transmutation wizard.
Bow before me, puny mortals!
Thanks to you, oh Dungeon Master, we are now jacked!
Oh, no need to thank me. You earned it.
Like unto gods, we march on to Rockport.
To Rockport!
It's, back this way, fellas. Welcome to Rockport. A city of industry, a city of dreams, a city on the move, a city on the grow.
A city that can't decide on a promotional slogan.
Again with the caves.
Excuse me, my good man. My name is definitely Lehman Kessler.
Ah, yes, Mr. Kessler. We've been expecting you. My name is Thomas. I am the concierge of the Rockport Limited.
Gee, Thomas, just the sound of your voice makes me feel so welcome.
And these two gentlemen are?
My retainers, Beau and Diddley.
He's kidding. I'm Lehman Kessler.
But I thought you said...
Hey man, Leon Kessler, my brother. My brother who works for me.
And I'm Ramos.
I'm totally confused. I thought he said...
Oh no, Thomas.
If you people are trying to pull some kind of ruse, it is very, very poorly constructed. I insist that you truthfully identify yourselves now.
Fuck it. I cast Charm Person.
And can I just say something? And this may sound weird, but I think the three of you are exactly who you're telling me you are. I'm just so charmed by you.
Nothing weird there.
Gentlemen, the Rockport Limited. The fastest, most powerful train in the realm. She'll make the 200 miles to Eversummer in 4 hours. The ultimate in luxury and comfort.
You gonna comp us some snacks? Maybe a tray or three of mojitos?
Oh, well, sure.
All right, let's get on that train! So we can grab the MacGuffin, get the hell out of here, and get back to the base before karaoke night.
Oh, yes, by all means, my good man. But first, I would like to check on my property.
You've got a hell of a lot of armed beef stationed here, Thomas. Something we need to know?
Oh, no, sir. Nothing to concern yourselves about. Nothing wrong here, just another typical murder-free day in Rockport. To limit access, our state-of-the-art cargo car is at the very rear of the train. No windows, which keeps it even more secure from marauders. Not that they'll be any problem. Thanks to the crypt safe. The crypt safe is indestructible and built into the very floor of the car.
Impressive. Let me view my property, sir.
Afraid that's not possible, Mr. Kessler. Your items have already been stowed in the crypt safe. It's time-locked. It will only open after an employee of the railroad, specifically the engineer, Mr. Hudson, maintains sustained physical contact with it for an hour.
It was a good thought.
Thomas, about all those guards.
Oh, Magnus! Thomas is a very busy man whose charm spell is going to wear off any second now.
In the interest of tying up loose ends, we could tell him to step in front of the train.
No! We've got more important shit to worry about! Like the fact that the artifact we're supposed to get is headed to Eversummer with or without us!
Sounds like the three of us will have to ride along if we're going to secure the payload. And I doubt there's any stealth reception in those mountains. So no help from the Bureau people either. We're on our own.
In that case, you two are going to have to do a better job of staying in character. Have you given the slightest thought to your motivation? Or your inner monologue?
All aboard!
Time to get your asses on the train that I spent hours coming up with. This is a full option train, my dudes. Fully luxuried out. This is the Lexus of fantasy trains. Gilded features, posh interior.
Is that shag carpet?
Yes, it is. Good eye, sir. I am Hudson, your engineer. Welcome aboard. We're happy to have you. We know you have a lot of choices for subterranean intercity travel, and we appreciate that you chose us.
Well, thank you for having us on your exquisite choo-choo.
You're in luck. We're riding light, so you'll have your pick of seating in the passenger car. And here we are at the engine car. This is where I will be for the duration of the trip. As a security measure, I will not be coming out again until we arrive at Eversummer. This is also where I must ask you for...
our tickets? Of course!
No, sir. Your weapons, please.
No. No, thank you. I don't believe I want to do that.
Mountain Train Security Agency protocols demand that all weapons be locked up with me in the engine car.
Goodbye, Smoosher. Goodbye, little Choppy.
Is it okay if I keep my umbrella in case of a storm?
Well, we'll be inside a train inside a giant mountain range, so not much chance of rain, but sure.
All right, but I have to hang on to my gauntlet. I have sticky hand syndrome.
He's not kidding. The stench will haunt your dreams.
Ah, fine.
But you have to do one thing for me.
What's that?
Let me sit on your lap and steer?
No.
Hudson the engineer, ladies and gentlemen. We hope you enjoyed him. We'll see him again at the end of the line.
He wasn't kidding about it not being very full.
And two of them are dwarves.
Look closer. I think the littlest one is a kid.
You don't think that's weird? Just some little kid traveling by himself on a train?
He's perfectly fine, sir. The Rockport Limited is perfectly safe. My name is Jenkins. Your wizard attendant for this trip.
I like your tie, Jenkins. Tell me about it.
You have an eye for the finer things, sir. This is my flair. We all get to wear one piece of flair on Tuesdays.
Good God, more bunk beds. It's as if every decorator in this reality spent way too much time at summer camp.
So are you an attendant who's a wizard or an attendant to a wizard?
I am a wizard who must attend to the needs of the passengers on the train. And I have a few luxury services I can provide. For instance, I can take you into our pleasure chamber. Sorry to disappoint, but it's not a sex thing. My soft and sensuous voice just makes everything sound salacious. It's a curse. The Pleasure Chamber is a recreational teleportation experience that allows passengers to briefly visit any enclosed space of their choosing anywhere in the world. The spell is powerful but limited. You can't bring anything back through the portal or leave anything there. Just in case you were thinking of doing any, you know, smuggling.
Lehman Kessler is no smuggler.
Like you'd know.
I saw a dwarven woman in the passenger car, and I swear I recognized her.
I'm not supposed to share the privileged information regarding the identity of—
Come on, Jenkins, old buddy!
I am not your buddy.
Oh, come on, Jinky!
All right. But you didn't hear this from me. That's Jess the Beaheader.
Holy shit, it is! She looks totally different without her grappling garb!
Grappling garb? Don't tell me you're a wrestling fan. Don't you know that's just a bunch of made-up fantasy bullshit?
She's a famous champion in the Mid-World Wrestling Federation! I was lucky enough to get to see her once. She was like a force of nature, with a very unique finishing move.
I'm guessing she doesn't cut their butts off.
I would love to sneak a peek at that axe.
Yes, I'm sure you would. But there's no chance of that during this trip. It's locked up there with Hudson. I had to lug the damn thing up there myself.
Kind of a shitty wizard.
I'm sorry, sir.
Just cast a spell of levitation. That stuff's second level, my man.
What am I going to do? Burn one of my daily slots on levitating an axe?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize that life on the rails was so demanding. You need pyrotechnics at your fingertips 24/7.
You should do what I do. Have unlimited spell slots and use every spell in the book.
Yeah, that's called cheating, actually.
Well, we wouldn't want to do that, would we?
Maybe you just need to live a little. Get out in the world and level up. That's all I'm saying.
I have no interest in your life hacks. Back there is the kitchen. I'm also the chef on this trip. Now that I know you, I'll be sure to bake a lot of love into whatever you order.
You're saving your spells for that.
Of course, beyond the kitchen is the cargo car. I'm sure you've been briefed on all the security protocols. No doubt most of it's sealed over your heads.
Jenkins, could you please open the window?
Certainly, sir.
But by all means, don't burn a spell slot on it.
Now see here, I live to serve the people on this train, and you cretins!
Easy, Jenkins, we're just joshing.
Please, gentlemen, we really must move ahead with the tour. It's nearly noon, and that's Jenkins' time.
As in
Jenkins' time to start fixing your brunch.
Well, there's no going back now. Maybe it's time you two got serious about solving this case. Because whoever killed the real Lehman Kessler is probably after the weapon. And if that person gets their hands on it, some extremely bad shit is going down. You better get busy helping me figure this out and completing our mission instead of spending all your energy on this ridiculous player thing!
You went through that whole spiel just to rip your sleeves off, didn't you?
Yeah. Too much?
No, Boo Boo. It was very powerful, moving even.